Parenting is hard work, but can you work too hard as a parent? New terms such as helicopter parenting, parents that hover too close to their child, have been created to describe parenting efforts that are well-intentioned but might go too far. So, for example, a parent might be protective of their child. Hi, sweetie! But perhaps that protection goes too far. Sweetie, I know you're 17, but driving's very dangerous. Why don't you wait until you're 30? Or perhaps they're teaching them very important life skills. That shoelace is undone. Let me do that up. But perhaps that assistance is given at an age where it's developmentally inappropriate. There you go. You have a great day at uni. My research is looking at overparenting. In the first stage of my research, I asked parenting professionals to describe the sort of actions they saw as being overparenting. And their responses fell in three main categories. In the first category, they described parenting actions that were highly responsive to children. For example, a parent considering their child to be their best friend, staying in constant contact with them even when they were an adolescent or an adult, or even believing the child is always right and never wrong. In the second category of parenting actions, they describe parents who were highly demanding of the child achieving success. For example, being top of the class all the time, being on every sporting team, or even being very socially successful by being very popular and invited to every party. It appeared that if the child was at risk of not achieving any of those successes, then parents were actually stepping in and assisting the child. For example, doing their homework, calling the school and demanding that they change their policy so the child experiences success at the school, or even contacting their child's peers and demanding that they invite their child to their party. The professionals said that these types of parenting actions were associated with child well-being issues such as poor resilience in children, a sense of entitlement in children, and also some tendency towards anxiety. In the next stage of my research, I'm looking at developing a measure of overparenting. And once that's finalised, I'm going to be using that to look at child well-being factors associated with this type of parenting. The parents that do this are working incredibly hard to give their child what they believe is the best start in life. Hopefully, my research and the results of my research will be able to take a little bit of the pressure off them.